Hello learners, welcome to part 2 of the prose lesson, The Little Girl, from your NCERT syllabus. Today we will read part 2 of the story. I'll explain it line by line along with the discussion of difficult words and their meanings, and then we will analyze the major themes, events, the title and its significance, and other such elements. So let's begin. In the first part of this video, we read about this little girl Kezia, who's very afraid of her father. Her mother doesn't pay much attention to her, but her grandmother loves her. The grandmother advises Kezia to make a pincushion for her father's birthday. Kezia does so and fills it up with her father's important papers instead of scrap clothes. This makes her father furious, who then punishes her by hitting her palms with a ruler. If you haven't watched the first part yet, I'll suggest you to pause this video and watch the first part, and then you can come here. If you have, then let's begin with the second part. Hours later, when grandmother had wrapped her in a shawl and rocked her in the rocking chair, the child clung to her soft body. So hours later, after being beaten up, the child is still crying. The grandmother is hugging the child and rocking her on a rocking chair. She's trying to pacify, calm the child down, and the child is clinging to her. Clinging means hugging her very tight. What did God make fathers for? She sobbed. So she's crying and she's saying, why did even God make fathers in the first place? Here's a clean hanky, darling. Blow your nose. Go to sleep, pet. You'll forget all about it in the morning. I tried to explain to father, but he was too upset to listen tonight. So his grandmother tells her to go to sleep, take a hanky, blow her nose and be calm. She tells her that she is going to forget all about it in the morning. But the child never forgot. Next time she saw him, she quickly put both her hands behind her back and a red color flew into her cheeks. So the child never forgot how she got beaten up by her father. So the next time she saw her father, she put her hands behind her back because she didn't want to be beaten again. The McDonald's lived next door. They had 5 children. Looking through a gap in the fence, the little girl saw them playing tag in the evening. So the McDonald's were her neighbors, Kezia's neighbors, and they lived next door. So Kezia looked at them through her fence, through a little hole in her fence, and she was looking at this family, the McDonald's family, right? They had 5 children and they were playing a little game called tag. Tag is a game where you touch one person and he runs after the other people to touch them. The father with the baby Mao on his shoulders, 2 little girls hanging on his coat pockets, ran around and round the flower beds, shaking with laughter. So look at this little girl. She's looking at this family through this little hole in her fence. There's a father there who has one child on his shoulders. The other 2 girls are hanging from his coat pockets and the boys are running around. They're playing. The whole family is playing in the garden. Once she saw the boys turn the hose on him and he tried to catch them laughing all the time. So these boys turned the hose. Hose means a pipe. So the boys turned the water pipe towards him and they all were laughing so much. They all were enjoying their time so much. Then it was she decided there were different sorts of fathers. Suddenly one day, mother became ill and she and grandmother went to hospital. So one fine day, her mother became ill and her grandmother took her mother to the hospital. The little girl was left alone. She was alone in the house with Alice, the cook. So there was Alice, the cook, in the house. That was all right in the daytime. But while Alice was putting her to bed, she grew suddenly afraid. So she was okay during the daytime with Alice. But when it was her chance to go to sleep, she suddenly became very afraid. What will I do if I have a nightmare? Now, what is a nightmare? A nightmare is nothing but a bad dream. So she's afraid of having a bad dream. I often have nightmares and then Granny takes me into her bed. I can't stay in the dark. It all gets whispery. You just go to sleep, child, said Alice, pulling off her socks. And don't you scream and wake your poor pa. So Alice tells her that it is going to be okay. You are not going to have any bad dreams. And you just go to sleep and do not scream and wake your father. Right? But the same old nightmare came, the butcher with a knife and a rope, who came nearer and nearer, smiling that dreadful smile, while she could not move, could only stand still. Still means without moving, right? Fixed in one position, crying out, Grandma, Grandma. She woke shivering to see father beside her bed, a candle in his hand. What's the matter? He said. So she had the same nightmare. She had the same bad dream in which there was a butcher and he had a knife. He also had a rope and he was trying to kill her. He was smiling this nasty, this really bad smile. He had a dreadful, very scary sort of a smile and she could not move at all. She was fixed in one position and she screamed, "Grandma, Grandma." When she opened her eyes, she noticed that her father was standing right next to her and he asked with a candle and he asked her what happened. "Oh, a butcher, a knife, I want granny." So this little child is so scared. She says, "A butcher, a knife, I want granny." She can't even complete one sentence that I have seen a nightmare and I want my grandmother. She's just talking in phrases. Look at how she's talking. He blew out the candle, bent down and caught up the child in his arms, carrying her along the passage to the big bedroom. A newspaper was on the bed. He put away the paper, then carefully tucked up the child. He lay down beside her, half asleep still, still with the butcher's smile all about her, it seemed. She crept close to him, snuggled her head under his arm, held tightly to his shirt. So the father blew out the candle, he bent down and he carried this little child, Kezia, into his big arms and he carried her along the passage to the big bedroom. He took her, he carried her to the big bedroom. He removed the newspaper from his bed and he put the child on the bed, right? He lay down beside her. So both the father and the daughter are sleeping, are now lying next to each other. Half asleep still, still with the butcher's smile all about her, it seemed, she crept close to him. So to her, it seemed as if the butcher is still there. But she is feeling safe. Why? Because she is lying next to the father. Right? She crept close to him. So she creeps closer to him. Right? Snuggled her head under his arm. So she snuggles, quietly keeps her head under his arm, held tightly to his shirt. So she goes closer to her father, almost hugs him and holds on to his shirt. Holds on to his shirt very tight, right? Then the dark did not matter. She lay still. So she lay very quiet without moving. She just laid there. And the dark did not matter. Now she's not afraid of the dark anymore. Why is she not afraid? Because she's next to her father. "Here, rub your feet against my legs and get them warm," said father. So he says, "Rub your feet against my legs and you can get them warm." So her father is also showing some love to her. Tired out, he slept before the little girl. A funny feeling came over her. Poor father, not so big after all, and with no one to look after him. He was harder than grandmother, but it was nice hardness. So, in the first paragraph, I told you how the grandmother was very soft to touch, and she was very cuddly, but father is very, very hard as compared to the grandmother, but this child still loves the father, and she thinks to herself, poor father, nobody is there to take care of this big man. She always used to think how big he is, but right now she doesn't feel like he is big at all, right? And every day he had to work and was too tired to be a Mr. McDonald. She had torn up all his beautiful writing. She stirred suddenly and sighed. "What's the matter?" asked the father. "Another dream?" So now this girl is thinking, oh my poor father, he works so hard. He has no time like Mr. McDonald's to play with us, to play with me, like Mr. McDonald's plays with his children. So she thinks that it is okay if my father doesn't play with me. It's okay because he works so hard. And she's thinking to herself, and she was also sorry because she tore up his speech. She tore his important papers, right? She stirred suddenly and then sighed. So she takes a deep breath. To sigh is to take a deep breath. "What's the matter?" asked her father. "Another dream?" So he asks her if she has another dream. "Oh," said the little girl, "my head's on your heart. I can hear it going." "What a big heart you've got, father dear." So in the end she says, "You've got such a big heart, father. You're such a good man." Now we will move towards the analysis of the main parts of the poem. First we'll analyze the title. The title is The Little Girl. So it clearly depicts that the story is narrated from the perspective of the little girl. Although the narrator is in third person, but he is looking at the world through the perspective of this little girl, right? We are given an insight into her thoughts and feelings. So she keeps on thinking to herself, whatever she's thinking, however she's feeling, we get an insight into that. That's why this title is apt. Symbolism. Now let's discuss what the father and the girl stand for. The father stands for authority and control. He's very strict, right? In the beginning, he gives people orders, and everybody around the house follows whatever he says. So he is the symbol of authority and control. The girl is a symbol of innocence and childhood. The girl is very sweet. She tries to make a pincushion for her father's birthday. She doesn't realize that these are important papers, so she tears them up and fills the pincushion with it. She's a very innocent child, right? So these are the two symbols that I was able to find. Now let's discuss the themes in the poem. There are two major themes. The first is relationships as dynamic connections. Dynamic means something that is not fixed, that keeps on changing with time. The father-daughter relationship undergoes a change during the course of the story. It shows that the relationships are always dynamic. So in the beginning, the daughter was very afraid of her father. She thought that the father was huge, was a very big man. And she was very scared. She also said that she wonders why God made fathers in the first place. But towards the end of the story, she says that her father has got a big heart. And she also thinks to herself that there is nobody to take care of this huge man. And she feels kind of bad for him towards the end. So towards the end, we have a loving, caring relationship. But in the beginning, we had a very strict relationship between these two people. Not a very loving sort of a relationship. There was no freedom. There was a lot of control. But towards the end, all of that control and freedom goes away. And love and compassion take its place. Right? Second theme is compassion and love versus anger and fear. So it's the same thing. In the beginning, it was anger and fear which predominated the mind of this little girl. Towards the end, it changed into compassion and love. So bonds require love and care to be nourished. Fear and authority destroys them. So from this story, we learn that if there is too much fear in any relationship, the bond is not true. You don't love each other that much. Be it father-daughter's bond or any other bond, right? So there needs to be an openness. There needs to be compassion and love for each other. There needs to be a consideration in the relationship for it to work. So these were the major themes. Now let's discuss the major events that happen and let's analyze what they actually mean. So the first one is Kezia's behavior around her father. If you notice that she approaches her father very slowly. In the first part of the story, we saw how she approaches her father very, very slowly. She doesn't go to him very willingly. She stutters in front of him. So she stammers a lot. She's not able to speak properly. And her father also scolds her. This shows that she's not very comfortable around her father. She's not even able to talk. She says that she doesn't stutter or stammer around anybody else, but only in front of her father. This shows that there is a fear in her mind for her father. Father beats up Kezia. So this is another instance that happens. Though it is to teach her a lesson, but she starts hating him. So she at one point says that she doesn't know why God made fathers in the first place, and she never forgets. The author clearly mentions that the child never forgot that incident. She never forgets the episode, right? So when he beats her up, their relationship becomes strained. There is a tension in the relationship. She hides her hands. She hides her hands behind her back the next time she meets him. This shows that she's very scared of her father again. There's tension in the relationship. And she is afraid of getting beaten up the next time as well. Major events. Kezia notices McDonald's playing. So she looks at this family who's playing in the garden. It draws a contrast between the two fathers. She thinks about her own father and she thinks about this father who's playing with his children. And she draws a clear contrast between the two kinds of fathers, right? Their location, the garden, is in contrast to hers. So she's in her home. Whenever she meets her father, he's always screaming. He's always giving orders around, orders to people. And they're always in their house, trapped inside the house. They're not playing, right? But the other family, their father is in the field, playing with the children, laughing. This is in direct contrast to Kezia's father, right? The laughter is significant as it denotes happiness. In her home, however, she never laughs with her father. So her bond is very strict. So this is an important event that happens, which shows us how her father is very different from Mr. McDonald's. Kezia has a bad dream. She screams, "Grandma, Grandma." So the dream signifies fear and trapped emotions. Her emotions are trapped. She is not able to express her emotions freely. This shows that the little child is very, very scared. And the first person that she calls out is Grandma. Why? Because the grandma loves her, unlike her father, who she doesn't feel very close to. Kezia sleeps clinging to her father's shirt. It signifies the protective image of her father and his love for her. So towards the end, she realizes that her father loves her and he has a big heart, and there are some things that he does that she doesn't like, but he still likes her and she still he still loves her, and she sleeps clinging to her father, and this shows that there's a bond of love and compassion between these two. This is it. Thank you so much for watching.